Hello and welcome back to Mayster Reviews. I'm very excited for this one. Today we're going to be talking about Glass Onion, a Knives Out mystery. Now, this film, oh wow. This might have actually topped the first one. It's cast doing a fantastic job, just like the first film did. But most notably, and hilariously so, Mr. Daniel Craig as Benoit Blanc. My God, I really hope this becomes the next major detective franchise as the rest of these begin to die out. I really hope it does. I hope the next era of mysteries and whodunits and crime films, Benoit Blanc is the face of it. I really hope so. And on top of that, Knives Out 3 is already in the works. Daniel Craig's performance here, he's allowed to have more fun with it this time, whereas I feel he was a bit more reserved in that first film, and I could tell that when I rewatched it before going into this one. And the similar elements of Rian Johnson's directing and fantastic writing is most certainly evident. And those same notes are there to the spirit of the first film, even though it's a completely different setting and style, are very, very present. And I'm so happy about that. So it feels like a true sequel, even though now it's almost basically like under new management, had a change of hands. It's now a Netflix film, and it still very much feels like it's the same talent. The cast do, again, an incredible job, but I would personally say, across the board, the cast from the first film do a better job. I mean, there's just so many more A-listers in that first cast. But, of course, there's so many others here as well. The setting and the budget throughout the entire runtime is particularly evident. I think they paid 400 and something million for Knives Out 2 and 3 Netflix. And if you split that in half, which I only assume was the case, and this is a $200 million film, on the same level as a Marvel film, it shows enormously, especially in the third act. The production design is absolutely, it's spotless. There's absolutely nothing wrong, I can say, about production design in this film. It was honestly perfect. Only a bit, arguably, a bit James Bondy and unrealistic at times like that. There's no way this would be a thing in real life. But at the same time, I give it a pass because of just how fun this film is. And then let's move on to the humour. The humour, again, the same as the first one. I was howling the whole way through. It's such a fun time. And Benoit Blanc is, of course, the comedic centre of that, where there's some definite serious beats, but his dynamic of the rest of the actors and the moving pieces of the puzzle and him playing off all of this, it's very funny. Very funny. Now, is there any particularly standout performances? I mean, Janelle Monáe did a great job, for reasons I won't spoil, but you'll know that she had a lot of range in this film, acting-wise, if you know what I'm talking about, and I was very impressed about that. And yeah, I think I've got two more talking points. Yes. Yeah, right. So Edward Norton is fine. I can't say, and I've got to say, I did kind of expect more from Edward Norton. His performance wasn't absolutely impeccable. I don't know. I think it was just because he went for the more dickhead rich person and he's more reserved, I think. A bit more like Daniel Craig's in the first film. I don't know. I just expected a bit more sort of pizzazz from him. But I guess, the same way that Kate Hudson was electric. And Dave Bautista did his best. The last thing I can talk about is probably along the lines of the negatives of the film, which a couple I've already previously described, but its biggest one is that its clues, I think, slightly varied to the first one, are actually a bit too complicated. It's a bit too clever. The gimmick in the first film about it being a suicide the entire time, and there wasn't actually a murder, was, well, at least until the third act, was brilliant. It was, that was the gimmick of that film, and it was so good to make the clues make sense. This one had to work a bit harder for a payoff that wasn't as satisfying as the first. But it's still a just as good film, if not better, as I've said already. Yeah, it was a bit too abstract and vague at times. Like, it was so explicit, the clues that were there, that you have to, and they're only shown once, you maybe need to show them multiple times to really drill it home. But then that could possibly give something away. He tried his best with a very complicated script that he'd written himself. And I think he did it justice for the most part anyway. So yeah, that what a fantastic film, honestly. So yeah, that is my review of Glass Onion and Knives Out Mystery. And I will see you all next time. Goodbye.